Hello everybody, Andrea Majewski here. So I am the owner of Dentalelle Mobile Hygiene. So as the name implies, I do have a mobile practice. And even me, I thought initially, well, nobody's going to want me to come to their house to get their teeth cleaned. Even me, I thought, oh, it just doesn't seem very professional. You know, why not just go to a dental office where you have all of the nice looking, I don't know, chairs, a nice desk, you know, just nicer, modern, even professional type of environment. You know, why would somebody want me to go to their house to clean their teeth, right? It just kind of looks weird. Would I want to go to my hairstylist's house to get my hair done? Yeah. Would I want to go to my massage therapist's house to get a massage? Yes. But did I always feel that way? No, because unless I'm saving money, I'd prefer, yes, to go to an actual storefront because things just look nicer. Things just look nicer. I don't know. It looks more professional. So I totally understand what you might be thinking and what some patients might be thinking too. But this is where, if you want to open up your own mobile practice, how you can change things and how you have to change things. So I have been actually a business coach. So I did that kind of while I was in dental assisting school because I've just always been a very techie person and I like to start things. I've always wanted my own business. So I have been a business coach as well. I've taken many, many courses. So advertising, marketing, I just kind of think of things maybe a little bit different. And this is how I want all of you guys to think about it too. So this is specific to if you want to do your own mobile practice. So you going to people's houses to clean their teeth, or even if you want them to come to your house. So it kind of works both ways. But you have to really sell the positive side of things. And that's what I'm doing. So feel free. I will leave the link for you guys of my Facebook page on the bottom. Feel free to have a look at that too, because you can kind of see how I post things. I keep talking about how amazing it is that I go to them. They have three kids. Well, hey, I will come to you. I can clean your teeth. Let's say I'm cleaning the wife's teeth. And then when I'm done, she can go do the laundry. She can get dinner prepared. I will clean the husband's teeth after that. And all the while, the kids are doing their homework. They're watching a movie. They're taking a nap. Who knows? And then I clean the husband's teeth. Well, then maybe while the wife is doing laundry, he can make dinner or he can set the table, whatever. You get the idea. And then I clean all three kids one after another. While the other two are watching a movie still. The first one's finishing his homework. The other one's outside playing with a friend. I finish cleaning someone's teeth. He says, hey sister, it's your turn, you know, whatever. It's so much nicer. They're in their own home. They're in their own environment. There's nothing to be anxious about. Kids, adults are anxious to go to the dentist. When I go to their house, even if they come to my house, they don't smell those dental office smells. They don't hear the dreaded drill. They don't look at the other staff members running around like this because they're 20 minutes behind and they're like insanely busy. They're hungry. They have to eat, but no, they're 20 minutes behind. They have to hurry, hurry. They're not seeing that. They're seeing me calm, relaxed, happy. It just gives them a much better experience. I mean, obviously certain things that I'm telling you guys, I don't say to my patients, such as, yes, when we're half an hour behind, we have patients yell at us. We are starving because we haven't eaten lunch. Oh, wait, we have to use the washroom too. It's only been about 45 minutes that I've been holding it. But if I take 2 seconds to use the washroom, the receptionist is going to yell at me. You know, I don't say that to them unless they're watching this right now. Sorry, but that's dental office life. But not if you go to their house, not if they come to your home. So we need to spin things differently. Seriously, you know, why is it that why a patient has no problem going to another office if their child needs extra attention? They need to see a pediatrician's office, or their gums need extra protection, so they need to go to a perio specialist, another office. If they need ortho, they go to another office to get the ortho done, but they have no problem coming back to the dentist for checkups and for their cleanings. So why not? We should change things. Have patients come to you, your home, because yes, we save a fortune having it in our home, or you go to their house and you clean their teeth. I want patients to see us as, well, now they can go somewhere else to have their teeth cleaned, have the best experience ever. They can ask as many questions as they want. We won't be behind because we're not going to overbook ourselves, and they can save money because yes, we have to go by, of course, we have to go by the fee guide, but you know, just the other day, I hate to say it, but I saw this nice senior patient. They did need a lot of cleaning because it had been a while. I had to charge them $265. Yet I know if I had seen them, how my pricing works is I would have charged him probably about $170. So here he spent $265 at the dental office where he could have seen me. I would have done the same thing because I'm the one cleaning his teeth. He could have seen me for $170, but of course I can't tell him that, right? Because that you're just not allowed to do that. Hey, come see me. No, you can't do that. You know, we can charge what we want and we're happy. You know, technically, if I saw every patient per hour for $100, I'd be happy because I'm still making $100 per hour. If you think about it, right? Yes, you have to pay for your expenses, you know, instruments, equipment, but you know, $100 per hour is better than making however much you're making at the dental office. But also, having that said, do not sell yourself short. I charge a minimum for adults, $130 for a cleaning. It's usually more than that because it depends on how much plaque or tartar and stain they have. And for children, it's about $65 to $100. So I'm just saying, don't sell yourself short because you might be thinking, I want patients. I'm going to offer like a $99 special, which is fine. If that's what you want to do, you're still making great money, but don't sell yourself short. But I'm different though, because again, I know how to do the advertising part of it. I travel to them. So I'm not going to be charging only $100, only $100. Yes, that's still a lot of money, but you know, I go to them. I am offering them an amazing service they can't get by them going to the dental office because they have to sit there. They have to wait. They're going to be behind. They might need x-rays, a dental exam. They might get talked into having a full mouth series plus a Panorex plus this plus that. Whereas they see me, I clean their teeth. I let them know what I feel they need, but I'm definitely not going to push a full mouth series every year and Panorex every year. No names mentioned, some offices do that, right? If you don't have insurance, even if you do have insurance, that's a lot of money. So think outside the box, you guys, and don't sell yourself short. Do not go, well, I can come to you to clean your teeth if you like. I know it's kind of weird I'm coming to your home, but I charge a lot less. That sounds horrible, right? You know, you should be saying, I come to you to clean your teeth. It's so much nicer. You're in the comfort of your own home. It takes me 20 minutes to set up. I clean your teeth. They will look amazing. In 20 minutes, I am out of there and you're still at your own house. You didn't have to travel anywhere. You didn't have to wait and wait and wait because the office is behind. You saved money. It's a win-win for everybody. I love what I do. So it's a win-win for me and it's a win-win for them. So you see how that works? So I hope this helped a little bit. This is how I explain things and my thought process with having a mobile practice and or having patients come to me because I save money. I don't need to rent even a tiny office space somewhere. I want it to look nice. You can save a fortune by even just redoing a room in your house to make it look how you want it to look. You're saving a fortune than having to get your own office space, having to pay another like rent, heat, hydro, setting it up to be a dental office, you name it. It's just better if you can and if you want to do it in your home, or to save even more money, travel to the patient's homes. So I hope this helped you guys. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.